us into going, but don't forget to keep asking. This is not just about going to Africa. This is in general. Even when you have it, you should still ask for it, right? Ladies, you're supposed to clap, man. Yeah, yeah. Keep me up for that one. What?
Yeah, so
okay. Let them keep asking. So you can say, no, I'm not in the mood. Okay, all right. Yeah? Okay, no, okay, now we get it. Anyway, all right, so we're gonna go back to the numbers. Because I want to hear the numbers that's going on. What's your number? 7. What's your number, Camille? Come here. Jeez. Don't hesitate. Come here. That's the number I was thinking about. Come here.
Number 12.
Come here. So Camille and I work. Yeah, this is a good picture. Camille and I work at the same job. Well, the same organization, nonprofit in DC. It's a social services agency. I'm director of communications and partnership. She is a social worker and she does an amazing job managing her team of how many? Lots. And so I heard her accent one day when I was walking in the hallway. This is me also sharing, right? And I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna talk to that one a lot. Because somehow some people at work think I'm stuck up. Can you believe that? I'm like, is it because my heels are always high and I look extra professional? I mean, what is it? But I've overheard that they think, I think I'm all that. And I said, I do think I'm all that. In fact, I know that I'm all that. And if you don't think you're all that, something is wrong with you, right? But I'm not walking around like, you know, in Jamaica, them say your voodoo can't make patty. Not like that, but you know. So anyway, Camille is such a nice lady. I speak to her at work. And I remember telling her about it. And she was like, oh, Rosie, I want to go, but I can't afford it. I'm like, yes, you can. Just come in. Oh, Rosie, I use all my money. I'm like, Camille, just pay it already. And she was procrastinating. And then one day she said, I have a check. And I'm like, just send it to Bomani. No, Rosie, can you come and get the check? I'm like, I'm coming downstairs now. So I took her check. I text Bomani. I'm like, yes, she's coming. And then the rest was her story. And then, you know, she came to the fundraiser and she was one of the persons who stood up with Nadia saying that they're going. And now like 6 people are promising to come next year. Yeah, 2016. So, you know, so they're accustomed to hearing me trying to motivate others because that's what I do. But when someone else says it, it's a different energy. So she's one of the voices that's going to be speaking on the behalf of Africa for the Africans and Ghana in particular when she goes back. And hopefully we'll bring more over next year. But Camille came from Haiti, right? And travel does wonders. When you travel and you sit down and you're not in your home country and you can just say things that's on your mind, you find out so much about others and about yourself that you're sharing. So we were sharing on the plane and, you know, we were sharing last night. And what I didn't ask her in particular is what's the difference between her experience in Haiti, and she left when she was younger, versus as an adult. Okay, my mistake. So that's a good question for you. Talk about some of the contrast that you've seen living in Haiti versus living in the States. And then maybe some parallels from living in Haiti to being in Ghana. Is that a hard question? No, it's not.
Actually, my name is Camille Benedict. I'm a clinical social worker. And currently I work with the seniors. So if you see me gravitated towards the senior, that's what it is.
We are noticed.
I fight, I advocate, I do the best that I can to make sure that they stay in their community. That's what I do. I talk to them. Many of them have a lot of loss, so I just love listening to them. I love them. So that's my job. I do advocate strongly for them. I go anywhere, the White House, wherever I need to go, I'll go and fight. And I am a fighter. I may be presented as calm and not talking and stuff like that, but I am a fast. I am a master of my life. I love people. I respect everybody. And this is all natural to me. I don't try to do anything. It just comes and I cannot help it. So if you see that, that's all it is. living in Haiti took me 8 years to adjust myself in the U.S. Total different life. Stinky life. It's still a stinky life for me in the U.S. I don't like it. I don't want it. If I can leave it today, I will. And it is a goal to leave it. I do not like it. I think the life in the U.S. are not for human beings. You have no time for family, for yourself.
Yes.
I mean, you get up early and come home late.
Yeah.
Get shot by the police.
Yeah. This is not for, just for me or any foreigners. I think it's for anybody who lives in the U.S. Or maybe should I say for all black people. Yeah. I do not like to refer myself as black.
Yeah.
Because I think I am a human being. So I do say I am a human being. I call myself Haitian. I do not identify myself as black. I am a person. I am Haitian.
Yes.
So when I go fill out paper and they say, Miss, what's your race? I say, what's that? I piss them off because they want me to say that I'm black. I say, no, where I come from? I'm Haitian. That's who I am. I'm Haitian. I do not identify myself as a color because I don't know what color is.
Yeah, that's all it is.
So I am Haitian, period. That's all I said. Can I change it? Isn't it what you do? That's all you do. You're always changing people's life. Go ahead. It's on you, not on me. So, that's what I said. So, yes.
Yeah.
But you know, it's funny because I'm... Would you say I'm introverted?
No. I think you're just peculiar about the things you say.
Okay, because I don't think I like to speak like this. I don't. So, okay. Life in the United States, no, I do not like it. I hope to change it, to leave it. I always want to come to Africa. I know Africa is my home.
Yeah.
That's where I'm from. I always know that I do belong here. And then being here and being in Haiti, no difference to me. I swear I grew up. Okay, that's my life. What you see here, it's my life.
Yeah.
So there's nothing new to me.
Yes.
So,
yes.
So when Pepe talked to me about coming here, even though that was always a goal for me to come, but I never had the way or path to go, so you opened that for me, Pepe, thank you. And then I always wanted to change my name.
Yes.
Is it Camille Benedict? What's that? even though I love Camille, that's not my name. Because if they didn't pull us away and disperse us the way they did, my name would be like Bomani. So it was always my goal to get my real name. So I'm hoping to do that.
Yay!
Yes, coming here was extremely overwhelming. It's amazing if you know what I forgot to bring. You know, it's very overwhelming, and I did bring Pepe. Even though when I made that decision, I paid my trip in 2 terms. Because that's how quick I done it once I made that decision. So, but extremely overwhelming. I cannot explain why. I didn't bring anything for our children here. I didn't bring anything to give. I said, I don't know what to do. I don't know what to bring. I said, I need to come and see. And then I said, okay, you need to stop it. Just come and observe. And that's what I'm doing. I'm observing.
Awesome.
So Let's love each other, okay? Let's treat us as human beings because that's who we are, and respect each other. And that's what I do.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Thank you, Camille. I'm so proud of my sister. All right, Camille. That was one of those moments that we spoke about. The emotional one. It's okay. Wipe it out.